Hello friends, we have already studied the basic principle of the earth fault protection. In this video, we are going to specifically study about the rotor earth fault protection. So let us study this in detail. So first of all, let us study the introduction. So basically, the rotor of the generator is not connected to earth, that is, it is unearthed. Therefore, it remains isolated from the earth, and single fault due to insulation breakdown will not rise the fault current. So, in case of rotor, as it is not earth, if one fault occurs due to the breakdown of the insulation, it will not be considered as a rise in the fault current because the rotor is not earth. So, a single fault will not affect the operation of the rotor. But if the occurrence of the fault continues, then it will damage the field winding of the generator. So one fault will not affect the rotor, but if the fault continues to persist, that is, if the fault occurs again and again, then the winding, that is the field winding of the generator, will get damaged. Therefore, for large generators, rotor earth fault protection system is used for the protection of the field winding. So, when one earth fault occurs in the rotor, then it is not necessary that the system will completely trip. Because there is no rise in the fault current, the system will not consider it as a fault condition. So, system will not trip. Only the relay will indicate that the fault has occurred. As a result, the generator can be taken out of the service. Now, the various methods of earth fault protection of the rotor are as follows. First is rotor earth fault protection by using the high resistance, and second is AC and DC injection method for the rotor earth fault protection. Let us study these methods in detail. So our first method is rotor earth fault protection by using the high resistance. Now in this method, a high resistance is connected across the field winding of the rotor. Now the midpoint of this resistor is grounded through a sensitive relay. When the fault occurs, the relay detects the fault and it will send a tripping command to the circuit breaker. As a result, faulty rotor or faulty part of the system will be disconnected from the healthy part of the system. Now here the figure shows the arrangement of the high resistance for the rotor earth fault protection. So if we see in the figure, the midpoint of the resistance is grounded through a sensitive earth fault relay. As a result, whenever the fault occurs, this fault will be sensed by the earth fault relay and it will disconnect the generator from the supply so that the generator will be protected from the earth fault. Now there are certain disadvantages of this method. Let us study them. So the major disadvantage of this system is that it can detect the fault for almost complete rotor except for the rotor center. Now the reason behind this is that, so if we see the figure, this resistance, at the center of the resistance, the sensitive earth fault relay is connected. As a result, the total part of the resistance is connected, or the total winding of the rotor can be protected except for the center of the rotor. Now, in order to overcome this difficulty, the tap on the resistor can be shifted from center to somewhere else so that the total part of the rotor can be protected. Thus, the relay can detect the midpoint fault as well, and it can send the signal to the circuit breaker so that circuit breaker will isolate the faulty part from the healthy part. Now, the second method is AC-DC injection method for the rotor earth fault protection. Now, as the name itself suggests, in this method, the alternating current is injected into the field winding and the ground circuit along with the sensitive earth fault relay. One current limiting capacitor is also connected. Now, a single earth fault which occurs in the rotor will complete its path through the circuit. Now, this circuit will comprise of, first is alternating current source. Second is sensitive relay. And third is earth fault relay. So whenever the fault occurs in the rotor, then that fault will complete its path through the circuit, which will consist of these components. Therefore, the earth fault will be sensed by the relay. Relay will give signal to the circuit breaker, and circuit breaker will isolate the faulty part from the healthy part. Now let us see this in the diagram. So if we see here, this is the total arrangement for the AC-DC injection method. Here we have the excited armature, then this is the generator field winding. So the AC current is fed into the generator field winding, then there is one resistor through which it will provide the path for the flow of the fault current. Then one current limiting reactor, that is a capacitor, is connected. Then here we have sensitive overvoltage relay. Then here are the auxiliary supply, that is, it can be AC or DC. Now let us see what are the disadvantages of this method. So the major disadvantage of this system is that there is a leakage current that might flow through the capacitor. As the capacitor is connected, there will be some amount of leakage current which will flow through the capacitor. Now due to this leakage current, the unbalance will be caused in the magnetic field, and it will increase the stresses on the magnetic bearing. There is another disadvantage, that is, the relay cannot pick up the current that normally flows through the capacitance to the ground. So whenever under normal operating condition, whatever current is flowing through the capacitance to the ground, it cannot be picked up by the relay. Suppose there is a fault and this current increases to a heavy value, this current will not be sensed by the relay. This is the another disadvantage. Therefore, it is necessary to avoid the resonance between the capacitance and relay inductance. So the value of capacitance which will occur across the capacitor and the value of relay inductance should not match. That is, there should not be the resonance between them. Only then this condition can be avoided. Now let us study what are the remedies over this problem. So this problem of AC injection can be overcome, or it can be solved by using the DC injection method. So instead of AC current, we have to inject the DC. Now this method is very simple, and it will have no problem of the leakage current. So one terminal of the sensitive relay can be connected to the exciter, and other terminal is connected to the negative terminal of the DC source. So the positive terminal of the DC source has to be grounded. So if we use this arrangement, whenever the earth fault occurs, the fault current will complete its circuit path and the fault will be sensed by the relay. So in this way, by using these two methods, we can protect the rotor from the earth fault. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekida and do subscribe our channel Ekida. Thank you.